I don't know. I think for me, sometimes I really like small clubs where it's down and dirty, and then I love playing in big outdoor festivals.
I kind of like the old theaters, opera house style theaters. There's some kind of classiness to it. Look like a ballroom.
Yeah, old theaters and small clubs and hockey arenas and big outdoor festivals. Those are my favorite.
He's a very well-rounded individual.
Okay. Well, do you guys think fame has changed the way you like play or see music, and why?
Probably has made us change the way we see music because we're kind of know all the ins and outs of everything about the music business now. So there's probably some sort of cynicism in there that happens.
And when you're touring, you get to tour with so many bands on festivals and things like that that you're always watching other bands all the time. So I'm sure you subconsciously kind of get some influence from those bands as well.
I would hopefully be working in talk radio.
You get it.
Thank you.
I'd probably still be an animator, computer animator.
I don't know what I would be doing. I think I would probably get into some sort of construction or something like that.
What about you?
Yeah. Something creative. I think actually I'd like to do something creative. Something with my hands, maybe.
Pottery?
Pottery.
Jewelry design?
Fishing, or maybe cook or something, open a restaurant.
Glass blowing.
Glass blowing.
That's
a
place in the streets called.
Those are
crazy.
It's hard to do.
Yeah, there's a whole
science
near Queen Street. You're on Queen Street.
I just broke the streets off by accident.
You broke your lips off.
Okay.
I don't think I'm doing it right. We don't really think about it. it's great. I mean, if we can inspire somebody to start playing an instrument or to start a band, then that's very important. You know, like there was lots of bands that we grew up loving and you know, admiring, and that's why we kind of picked up these weird instruments and tried to figure them out. So
awesome.
It's a privilege.
Yeah. Can you guys describe the feeling when you walk on stage, the initial moment?
It's, you're kind of nervous, but when you get out there and the crowd starts cheering, it's a, kind of like a rush of adrenaline.
John?
I can't really describe it.
Yeah.
It's just a feeling, you know? It's exciting.
It's like when you first were like making out with girls, you know, like, you know, nervous and your heart's racing, you're not sure if you're doing it properly, and then you kind of just get into it. This is fun. A pro.
Casanova.
Casanova over here.
Wait, how much of a difference is there between being on tour and being at home?
Definitely more rested at home.
Yeah,
quiet.
Being at home, you relax and you know, catch up with friends and family and things like that. But when you're on the tour, it's like go every day. So.
Yeah.
It's a very strange life.
Is it?
Yeah. Like, it doesn't make any sense. And we've been doing it now for 17 years as a band. We've been touring for about, what, 8 years?
8 years.
And, it ages you. You see these lines and start to clear out. And it's like, really? And I'm like, shit.
Out of your albums, which would you say is your favorite and why?
The Jukebox EP.
I'd say the new album.
The new album?
Yeah. I love playing guitar for someone. So.
Yeah, right now I'm into the new album the most.
Yeah.
Just, you know, it's all fresh and new and fun and playing the songs for people for the first time.
Yeah,
it's,
I guess so.
It's really
fun.
Yeah.
I love them all. They're all great.
Yeah.
They're like, yeah, having three different kids. You love them all the same.
On your latest album, from what I hear, you incorporate different instruments. Do you guys think you'll be doing that on new albums, like upcoming ones?
Yeah, I mean, possibly, if it really fits or suits the song. We we went in wanting to just do bare bones recording, but Brandon kind of opened our minds to to adding additional percussion and piano and things like that. So, and it, it really added to the album.
Yeah.
So,
I don't. I think the one thing that we learned on this record about doing that is to not is to keep your mind open and be open for suggestions.
Mm-hmm.
And even if it sounds really weird to try something, like we had a clavis chord or whatever,
clavichord,
which is I don't even know what it is.
Yeah.
And mellotron, and you know, so we just and all things that sound really weird. But if you try them and it sounds great, then keep it.
Awesome. That's all I have to ask
you. Well, good job. Good work.
Thank you.
Good job.
Good question.